Welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to learn how to deploy your report on the report server. So let's get started. So the agenda of this video is that we will learn how to add column totals to a table. Then we'll learn how to connect to a report server from the report builder. We'll learn how to save your report builder in the report server, opening your report server on the web portal, deploying your report, viewing and managing your deployed report, modifying reports connected to the report server, and we'll learn how to organize your reports in the web server. And last but not least, we'll learn how we can automatically connect to the report server in your report builder. So let's get started. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to open our report that we had saved in the previous session. So I'm just going to go to the folder and I have my report saved here. I can double click and it will automatically open. So there we have it. So this is the report that we had designed in the previous session. What we're going to do now is we're going to add a total at the bottom to show how many records has been printed. So in order to add a column total at the end, what we're going to do is click on the last row. We're going to just highlight the last row and I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to select insert row outside the group and below it. So this is what I'm going to select. If I select inside the group and below, what it's going to do for each individual row, since it's inside the particular group, so for each individual row it will do its count, and that's not what I want. I want the count to show at the end as a summary, so that is why I'm going to put it outside of this group and below. So let's click on do that, and then what I'm going to do is at the end I'm going to click on this field and I'm going to select the value that I want the system to the count of, and I want the system to the count of an ID. In this case, I want it to do of an employee code. And now I don't want the employee code to show. I want the count or the sum to show. In order to do that, double click on it. And then once it gets highlighted, I'm going to right click on it and click on summarize by. This gives me the option to summarize it by a sum count to its maximum, to its minimum. This is how I can apply summary. So right now we're just going to do a count of all the employee codes, and what I want to do is I want to put a total over here, so it will give me the total. So you can notice there are two blank spaces over here. So what I would do is I would match all these three cells together so that it can all read as total. And to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Control on my keyboard and then I'm going to select the rest of the cells. What it will do is it will combine all together, as you can see over here. And then what I can do is I can click on the match. So what this will do is it will match the cells. So as you can see, this is now matched. So if I want to indent, I can indent it, and if I want to make it bold and have a different background color against that, I can do that. And likewise for the count as well, if I want to show a different background color, I can do that. So now let's run this report. Okay, when we run the report, if I go down, you'll see that there's a sum, there's a total which shows me the count. Now the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to learn how we can connect this report builder that we have opened directly to the report server. So to do that, if you notice at the bottom left hand corner, you'll see that there's a message that shows no current server and the option to connect. So when you click on connect, what this does is it will prompt you to select the report server in which you want to connect this report builder to. And I'm going to select the drop down option, and based on your report server that you have configured, you can select it. In this case, I'm going to select, and you most probably will have one. In this case, I'm going to select my option over here. I'm going to click on connect. So it's going to connect. Once you're connected to your report server, this means that you can directly upload your report onto the report server without the need to actually go and manually upload it. I'm going to show you how to do that. So in this step, we're going to learn how you can save your report directly on the report server. To do that, you'll go onto the file option and then you're going to select save as. This option will come, and then instead of now saving it on your machine, we're going to select recent sites and servers. When you click onto that option, you would be given the list of your reporting services in which you want the report to save it. You will most likely again have one option over here, and so to select that, you're going to double click on it, and then you most likely again will have a blank report. In this case, I have reports that I have already designed. So what I'm going to do is I have created a folder over here called SSRS tutorial. So I'm going to double click on it and save it on that clean folder so that this is this document is saved onto that tutorial folder. So if you want to change your name, you can change it, but I'm going to leave it as it is, and I'm going to click on save, and your report has now been officially deployed on your report server. To see that, we're going to open our report server from the web portal. Now to do that, you will open your report server configuration manager. I have it pinned to my start, so I'm just going to click onto it. If not, you can just type the name of it. It's called Report Server Configuration Manager, and you should get that option. Once you're prompted with this, you'll be required to select your report server instance. In most of the cases, it will be your default instance, as in mine. I'm going to click on connect. So your reporting services is already running, as you can see. What we're going to do, what we are interested in, is getting the link of the web portal. So click on the web portal URL over here and use this link to browse on your web browser. Click on it. It will open it for you. So I'm going to click on this folder that I have created, and you can see the report has already been uploaded automatically without the need for me to do so. So that is how you can directly connect your report server from your report builder and save your report from there and have it uploaded on your report server web portal. Now, if you want to manually do that, you can also do that by clicking on the upload option over here. As you click onto that, you'll be required to browse, and all you have to do is just select that, and it will select the document and it will get uploaded. But what we're going to do now is how you can view and manage your deployed reports. So once you have this report set up, all you have to do is just click on it and your report will run over here. And there you go. So this is no longer in the design stage. This is the actual web portal where your report has now been linked. So if you want, you can export your report in these formats. And if you want to go back, you can click on this arrow, click on this link over here, and it'll take you back. Or you can click on the back from your browser and it will take you back. If you want to delete your report, you're going to click on these three dots over here. And then you have these additional functions that you can perform. Now, this is more of a SQL reporting services web portal tutorial. I will make a video about this and I'll upload it within this series. And so you can have a full walkthrough of how this works. But for now, what I just want you to do is click on it, how you can run the report. If you want to download it, you can download it. If you want to delete it, you can delete it. If you want to move your report somewhere else, you can click on it and you can move it anywhere else. If you want to create a folder over here and move it to that folder, you can also do it. So you click on new and create a folder for this as a playlist. And if I want to move this report, I'll select on move, and then I can select the folder name. And in this case is the employee list, which is for in management, is within the SSRS tutorial folder. And there you go. So if I move this in, and if I just reload, you will see that there's a folder, and inside that folder, there is my report. Now, if I want to modify this, what I can do is I could go back and modify it over here and save it. It will get modified. What I could also do is I could click. So let me just close this. What I could also do is click on this three icon and click on edit report builder. It will ask me to open your report builder. I'm going to select that option, and then I can still, it will connect me to that report server, and then I can directly start changing it from here as well. It's down to personal preference on how you would want to modify your reports. Either you can open your report from where you have saved it from, and then connect it to the report server and then save it, or you can just go directly on the web portal and click on edit report builder and directly work on it from here. So there you have it. Now what you can do is, if you want anytime you open your report builder, if you want it to get automatically connected to your report server, then there's a way to that. So let me just open my report builder, as you can see. So right now, again, if you can see at the bottom, it's still asking me to connect because this is a new file and it hasn't been connected. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to update my settings so that every time I open my report builder, it automatically connects me to that web server. Now to do that, I'm going to go to file and then I'm going to go over here and select options. As I click on options, you'll see over here, use this report server by default. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place my link over here of my report server. Now, in order to find the link of my report server, I'm going to open my reporting services configuration manager. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to web service URL and I'm going to click on it. And I'm going to copy this. I'm going to go back to my report builder and I'm going to paste this link over here. And then I'm going to click on OK. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to close my report builder and I'm going to open it again. And you would see at the bottom, it has automatically connected me to my report server. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, please do give a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Here are other videos that you might find useful.